the morning star, drive on 17.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star, drive, you know.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Friday, July 2nd, and this is the Morning Star Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is happening today on this fabulous Friday? We got some coronavirus updates, current news from around the world, we have a word study on the great songs, and then back to the MBTI segment with One Chum. Alright guys, how are you doing today? The week is over and we're already at the weekend. I'm super happy and super excited for what's going to happen. Not only for my break time, usually Friday is my break, and Saturday and Sunday get a little bit more busy, but super grateful and thankful. I hope that you guys are going to enjoy an awesome weekend. Looking forward to some fun, relaxation, realizations, direction. Just what does God want from us for next week? And are we going to finally fulfill this week's message of evangelism? Hope that you guys contacted a lot of people and planned it out really well too. So let's get things kicked off here together on the Morning Star Drive. So keep liking and commenting. I want to hear from you guys and see how you're doing. So post your song requests, questions, and stories too. Testimonies are all welcome. So go ahead and do that. Espresso with Sky channel has a new video coming out tonight. So go ahead, check that one out. It's about why I quit alcohol. Of course, yes, we don't drink in Providence, but I actually quit alcohol before coming to Providence. And that was at before 19, so it's a pretty crazy story. I have a story between me and my mom that made me want to stop drinking. It's kind of weird though, because right now my mom's like, "Why don't you drink a little bit?" I'm like, "No, mom, I made a promise." And she's like, "No, you don't. It's okay. You don't have to keep it." I'm like, "No, I want to keep it." Also, Sunday edition, we're going to go to Australia and we're going to meet Nick Loader, and he's a member of the Brisbane Church. So go ahead, check out that interview. It's going to be really good. Someone running really hard for the Lord. So be sure to check it out. Check out the interview on the Sunday edition. And of course, this week we are meeting Gita Salim. Go ahead, look at that interview. She is one of the first Indonesian members running in that pioneering church. So check that out and you can get a better idea of how you can pray for that church too. Also, I hope you guys really enjoy these Sunday editions. Just getting to meet each other in a more intimate way, hearing our stories, our testimonies. I hope that you guys can all get inspired and moved by that too. All right. Also, just want to let you guys know, Patreon, there's new videos every single week. They're exclusive only to Patreon. And this week we've added the lecture Q&A, or basically it's taking the Sunday message points and making them into lectures. Okay. All right. So let's get into today's feature arts of the day on this relaxing Friday. We're going to start off with Man and Groom from PMA in Korea. And that song is going to be called How Can I Be a Good Man? This is one of his newest songs that came out. Second is Juice Star Aiden Verity from New Zealand with Wisdom is the Best. And then we'll end things off with Kumachung from Japan with Open My Eyes. So as we are here on the 32nd day of, we're almost at the halfway mark, guys, 32nd day of the 70-day prayer condition. I hope all of you guys here are having amazing time of prayer, but make sure more than anything else, just put in a little prayer for all these member artists from around the world.
I can't, baby, be 봐도 나는 너 yeah. 내 목에 줄이 채워지는 건 용납을 no. 삶은 더 올라가 아무래도 솔직해질래 친구라도 잘못된 건 잘못된 거 yeah. 공부만 하는 새끼들 필요해 보이네 묵상이 의미 없는 종교는 병들게 하지 잘 들을 건데 아무 말도 안 하는 게 일함 난 배외 양아치 물론 첫째로 자신에게 떳떳하게 나그래 내 발 목이 잡혀도 더 세게 차버릴래 이게 내게 게라도 남 내 목에 줄 안 걸래
どんな困難迫害が来ても動じない強い信仰を持って立ち向かおう。ファミリーでゴー、ファミリーでゴー、全ての人を受け入れられる家族のような温かさを持って行こう。主の御心ファーストで行こう。いつも主の信条と共に主の言葉を最優先にして動き出そう。伝えよう御言葉を実践し挑戦してナンバーワンを目指して行こう。全ての個性才能を生かし挑戦しよう。主役になろう。伝えたい I'm happy, I'm happy 新しく You are shining, you are shining 伝えたい I'm happy, I'm happy 新しく You are shining, you are shining。オープンでこう、オープンでこう、地域や社会の目線に立ち、発展に積極的に貢献しよう。近づいてこう、近づいてこう、すべての世代と距離を近く、親しく接したのは僕をなそう。縛られてる心を捨ててこう、新しい取り組みをしよう。主の言葉で心を燃やして動き出そう。どんどんチャレンジしよう。家族のような温かさで愛に満ちた教会しよう。 CGM オープンの先駆者として強みを生かし大胆になろう。伝えたい I'm happy, I'm happy 新しく You are shining, you are shining 伝えたい I'm happy, I'm happy 新しく You are shining, you are shining。
An exciting song by Kuma Chung from Japan with Open My Eyes. Before that, Juice Star Aiden Verdi from New Zealand with Wisdom is the Best. And of course, the featured artist of the day today is Man and Groom from PMA in Korea. And that song is How Can I Be a Good Man? So let's get into some news going on around the world on this last day of the week. We'll start off with the coronavirus update. We're at 183 million cases in the world with 3.9 million deaths at a 2.16% mortality rate. And yes, by the time the weekend's done, we're going to be at 4 million cases. 4 million deaths, so that it's getting pretty bad. Well, it's been bad for a long time, but let's just hope that it's really coming to an end. Top five countries going by daily infection rates. We have India on top with 30.4 million cases and 399,000 deaths, which means India will hit 400,000 deaths by Monday. Brazil, 18.5 million cases, 518,000 deaths. The UK, 4.8 million cases, 128,000 deaths. Argentina in fourth with 4.4 million cases, 94,000 deaths. And Colombia rounds up the top five with 4.2 million cases and 106,000 deaths. So now let's take a look at it going by daily infection rates. So India and Brazil are 1 and 2 with 48 and 45,000 cases in a single day. Colombia at 27,000 cases. The UK at 26. And then Argentina comes back in the top five with 22,000 cases in a single day. Indonesia, they've always been number six for the past week. They're either number five or six, and they're still at 21,000 cases in a day. So it is getting pretty bad over there, and a lot of people are looking for the vaccines over there too. Malaysia is Malaysia is in second place with 6,200, and then the Philippines is remaining pretty low in the 4,000s with 4,500 cases. So that is coronavirus updates for today, which means we'll go into the top three newsworthy items. Okay, top three newsworthy items. And two of them have to do with Canada. So the first one is, we talked about the heat wave yesterday. And guys, the deaths are skyrocketing in Canada. There are at least 486 sudden deaths recorded in British Columbia since Friday as temperatures soar on Canada's west coast. And authorities say nearly 500 people have died in Canada's westernmost province across 5 days. Guys, 100 people a day, as record-breaking temperatures raise serious concerns for vulnerable groups, including the elderly. British Columbia's chief coroner, Lisa Lapointe, said on Wednesday afternoon that the BC Coroner Service received at least 486 reports of deaths between Friday and Wednesday afternoon. A total, she said, was preliminary and expected to increase. So the fatalities represent a 195% increase from the approximately 165 deaths that would normally occur in the province across a 5-day period. The last 5 days in British Columbia have seen an unprecedented number of deaths reported to the BC Coroner Service. So while it's too early to say with certainty how many of these deaths are heat-related, it is believed likely that the significant increase in deaths reported is attributable to the extreme weather BC has experienced and continues to impact many parts of a province. Now, temperatures have soared in BC and other Canadian provinces and territories as a so-called heat dome, a weather system that traps in hot air, descended on the country's west coast as well as in the Pacific Northwest of the United States. And experts have also said climate change contributed to the record-shattering heat. Lytton is a town in central BC, broke Canadian high temperature records 3 times this week, hitting up to 49.6 degrees Celsius or 121 degrees Fahrenheit on Tuesday. And Metro Vancouver police said on Tuesday evening that officers had responded to more than 65 sudden deaths, right? So from yesterday, we were reporting there was only about 34. Now there's up to 65 sudden deaths, okay? While police in Burnaby and Surrey, cities in the greater Vancouver area, also reported dozens of sudden deaths. The vast majority of these cases are related to the heat, is what the Vancouver Police Sergeant Steve Addison said in a statement, and we've never seen anything like this, and it breaks their hearts. If you have an elderly or vulnerable family member, please give them a call or stop by to check on them. A heat warning remains in effect for the greater Vancouver area, but Environment Canada said it's on its website that the heat will become less intense. So starting on Wednesday, though temperatures are likely to stay unseasonably warm for the rest of the week. So that is the first thing happening in Canada. But the second thing is another, it's just some more sad news in Canada happening right now. We did talk about this before, about these unmarked graves that are found on these residential school sites that the government made for the Aboriginals, the First Nations people in Canada. And it's pretty incredible what they're finding at like near each of these sites. So once again, almost 200 unmarked graves found near another Canada residential school. So an Indigenous nation in Canada said it has found the remains of 182 people near the grounds of a former residential school in British Columbia. The Lower Kootenai Band said it is too early to say if the remains belong to former students of the school, but the discovery adds to a rising tally of such unmarked grave sites across the country. And the grim finds have prompted national outrage and fueled calls by some to cancel the July 1st Canada Day holiday. Now, Indigenous leaders have said they expect more graves will be found as investigations continue, but you can never fully prepare for something like this. And this is what the chief, Jason Louis, of the Lower Kootenai Band, which is a member of the Tunaxa clan nation. Okay, so the community community of Tunaxa is one of 4 bands in the Tunaxa nation, used ground penetrating technology to uncover the grave sites close to the former St. Eugene's Mission School near Cranbrook, British Columbia. And some remains were found in shallow graves, only 3 to 4 feet deep. St. Eugene's was operated by the Catholic Church from 1912 until the 1970s, and it was one of more than 130 compulsory boarding schools funded by the Canadian government and run by religious authorities during the 1920 centuries with the aim of forcibly assimilating Indigenous youth. So we did report the beginning of the week that 4 Catholic churches were already burned down because the Catholic Church was the one that was, you know, basically running these schools where these unmarked graves were found. So up to 100 of the Lower Kootenai Band were forced to attend, the group said, but the remains were found on the grounds of a different cemetery, which dates back to 1865, and burial plots used to be marked with wooden crosses that crumbled over the years. So these factors, among others, make it extremely difficult to establish whether or not these unmarked graves contain the remains of children who attended the St. Eugene Residential School. So the news comes amid a national soul-searching over Canada's legacy of residential schools. And in May, we're looking 2 months ago, the remains of 215 Indigenous children were found in unmarked graves in Kamloops, British Columbia. Then last week, leaders of the Coes First Nations said the remains of 751 bodies, most of them children, were discovered at the former site of another school in Saskatchewan. And this most recent discovery comes on the eve of Canada Day, which is July 1st, meant to mark the same date in 1867 when three British colonies were joined to create the Dominion of Canada. So many Indigenous people in Canada have never recognized Canada Day, a sentiment that has grown in recent weeks, and municipalities across Canada have canceled upcoming celebrations, and statues of figures involved with residential schools have been vandalized or removed throughout the country. So speaking on Wednesday, Prime Minister Justin Trudeau said the discoveries have forced us to reflect on the historic and ongoing injustices that Indigenous peoples face. So Canada Day is going to be a day where we celebrate, but we will mostly reflect on the work that we all have to do. So that is the second news from Canada, which is pretty terrible to hear about unmarked children's graves. Last but not least, we're going to go to China. Right? China, who's best friends with Canada, if you guys hear the news and politics. But the CCP is celebrating their 100 years. So Xi Jinping, which is the president of China, warns that they will not be oppressed by other countries in their anniversary speech. So President Xi Jinping said that China does not oppress other countries at a speech marking the 100th anniversary of the founding of the ruling Communist Party. And in comments seen as a reference to the U.S., Mr. Xi also warned against anyone oppressing China, saying they would have their heads bashed against a great wall of steel. So if that's not a threat, then yeah. So the vetted crowd of 70,000 erupted in cheers in Beijing's Tiananmen Square, and many of them were not wearing masks. And the ceremonies on Thursday morning also saw military jets fly, do flybys, and cannon salutes and patriotic songs played. So the country has seen a media blitz in recent weeks promoting a party-approved version of China's history, and Hong Kong is also marking its handover anniversary on the same day. So what else did Xi Jinping say? He said that he spoke for around an hour, reiterated the role of the party in modern China, saying that it has been central to the country's growth and that attempts to separate it from the people would fail, and only socialism can save China, and only socialism with Chinese characteristics can develop China. So he also added that they will never allow anyone to bully, oppress, or subjugate China, and anyone who dares to try will have their heads bashed bloody against the Great Wall of Steel forged by over 1.4 billion Chinese people. And China has repeatedly accused the U.S. of trying to curb its growth, and these comments are also seen as a reference to Washington. He also mentioned Taiwan, noting that China maintains an unshakable commitment to unification with the island, and no one should underestimate the resolve, the will, and the ability of the Chinese people to define their national sovereignty and territorial integrity, right? So on for Hong Kong and Macau, which he said both retain a high degree of autonomy, they should accurately implement the principles of one country, two systems. So that is quite interesting that he says anyone who comes against China will have their heads washed, bashed against a wall of steel. Here we go. So this is just kind of leading up to something much bigger. So I hope that we can pray about the situation too, that if anything, God's will be done. Okay, so that is the news for today, guys. Hope you guys really were able to see what's going on around the world, which means we're going to go into some spiritual time with Song of Praise and Worship. We're going to start with Grab Hold of the Heart, then to the new songs of the Lord, and then we'll finish off with The Path of Love. So as one body of the Morning Star Drive, let's spend this time giving glory, honor, and praise to the Holy Trinity.
People's hearts to burn up like blood and flow away. When your heart's left alone, it goes to waste, thoughts in vain. Your heart flows away. Now grab your heart and control your deeds. Lead them on to love, lead them to the Lord, pressing on. you should press ever on towards the Trinity.
since I have come, you've come as well. And today we become one with God, one with the Spirit. We unite on this path, this path of love we must walk. Now and for all eternity, this path will never change. Hear the word flows without end. Proudly we go on, always for providence. Now and always hope will shine brighter than the sun. This eternal love and hope forever shine. This love of ours fulfilled God's will at last. The Lord our God promises will not fail, they will stand without change.
The Path of Love. Before that, the new songs of the Lord. And of course, the first song was Grab Hold of the Heart. So let's get into some word study for today. It's a little bit different because, you know, it feels like we haven't had a great songs service for like 2-3 months. It's been a while since we've had one, so it was good to, like, for me, it was just suddenly like, oh, it's great songs. Oh, I didn't know. So it was kind of cool to have this great songs come out again. We had 3 songs, and they worked out really well. Of course, the first song was "A Love Without Regrets," and I like the intro to the first 2 songs mainly because they came on special days, which means that something was coming off some type of a high, right? He's coming off some type of a high. Like the first song was "Love Without Regrets." Great vibe to the song. They had the rap in the middle, which I really, really enjoyed. And it's after 3:16 pre-dawn. Sunseem is full of grace. He has all these thoughts of what God did for him. And thinking back of the 43 years of history, what God has done, coming off this type of a high, he's making a song, Love Without Regrets, right? And this is amazing because if you're thinking about everything God has done for you the last 43 years and in his entire life of like almost 80 years now, how could you have any other regrets when everything God has done for you, you've pulled through? So I really like that intro to that first song, Love Without Regrets. And it was a really cool vibe. That's a song that I really hope that it soon comes out in English. And I hope maybe like the Sumney Boys can do the rap part of it too. It was really, really good. And, you know, the whole point just there in itself is we raptured because of love. And because of love, we're able to live together. And we all have to have that confidence that the rapture has been fulfilled, like that absolute confidence. The way Sunseem put it is just like if you're a man, you know you're a man. Well, maybe in America it's a little bit different, right? Because if you think you're a woman, whatever it is, right? But we're talking about the normal person is thinking, yeah, if you're a man, you know you're a man. You're 100% confident. And that's the type of confidence we need when it comes to we fulfilled the rapture. And I know that some people might have doubts if they are raptured. But we cannot deny that the rapture was fulfilled because you yourself being raptured is a personal responsibility and it's up to you. However, the rapture itself has been fulfilled and it's a matter of us just feeling, it's us, you know, depends on what day it is, you know. We're like, oh, am I raptured? Oh, I don't know if I'm raptured. And sometimes when you're not doing well, you might feel like you've lost your rapture. But the actual fulfillment of the rapture is not something that we doubt. It's more of, am I raptured? It's kind of the bigger thing that people think about more, right? So I really like that very first song. Second song, also, just the title, Pray at All Times, it just comes at the perfect time where Sunseem is asking, hey, Holy Spirit, what kind of song do we want? And Holy Spirit straight up, like this is Alpha Day. And it's not only just Alpha Day, the beginning of history, but it's the beginning of the 70-day prayer condition. And, you know, basically the message that week was basically don't be worried, don't be anxious. Everything will be resolved through prayer. So pray diligently. And Sunseem was even testifying that, yeah, you know, think about this all my life through my prayer, right? I've received so many things through prayer. And the one that was really intense, the story he gave was when, you know, when he was kind of the last moments of his time in China, when he was being tortured and interrogated for 10 months is when they basically put a hood over his head and took him into the mountains and he thought he was going to die and he was scared for his life. And the Holy Son said, like, you know, don't worry, you're not going to die because I'm with you. But if you think about it carefully, like, imagine God saying that to you, but you still have a hood over your head and you have no idea what's going to happen. And, you know, Sunseem was like, but what if I die kind of thing, right? And it's really heart-wrenching when you think about that because it's that scary. And the Holy Son's like, hey, it's me. I'm telling you. If you don't believe me, I'm just going to leave then, right? And you have to understand, it was such an intense situation, but it was something that, you know, Sunseem talks about, he's been saved all his life through prayer. It's always been about prayer. And he also talked about Vietnam. He had the same fear on the 2 tours. He keeps, you know, even though he knows God was with him and God was protecting him, but he, you know, imagine you keep hearing stories of people dying in the next unit and people dying in the next platoon, in the next battalion. They're all dying. And he's like, what, God? You know, are you serious, right? And Sunseem even got to the next point where it's like, okay, Sunseem, okay, he's like, okay, God, okay, so I believe I'm not going to die, but what if I become disabled? What if I become handicapped from this? Like, come on. And then God's like, you know, come on, like, you got to trust me on this one. If I'm with you, I'm not going to allow you to become handicapped, all right? And it's such a rewarding feeling, this song of Pray at all times. It's the one of the reasons why people don't pray is because they don't realize how powerful prayer is. That's the biggest reason. If you prayed and every time the prayer came true, you'd be like, let's pray. But if you don't pray a lot, what happens is you don't realize the power of prayer. And even when someone offers to pray for you, you won't even accept it because you don't realize how powerful prayer is, right? So we have to realize at that time, it is such a big thing. It really, really is. And if people knew the power of prayer, they would never reject anyone's prayer for them, especially when they pray over them. It's such a big thing, even in the scriptures, that we should get together and lay hands on people and pray for them like that too. So, the great advice I liked, and then one of the best advice was, if you can't pray deeply, start talking about the things that have already been done for you in the past, and then you'll gain fire, and then you'll go deep into prayer again. So like, that's one of the hints that God gave through the message. And I think that's something really, really amazing that we have to put into practice when it comes to not getting into deep prayer, right? So basically, guys, what Sunseem said in that second song was, if you guys don't think so lightly about the great songs that there's no sermon, there's no word, because the song is the sermon and the explanations are the sermon. So you have to listen very carefully. There's so many tips and hints and word that's coming out that God is speaking to us that we have to really listen even more. That last song, Rapture is Love, is like supposed to be like the, what do you call it? The epic, you know, the highlight song. And, of course, the introduction, it wasn't as significant as in, like, say, it was on Alpha Day or it was on 316, but it was during the week of such a great message. He said December 4th, 2018, so that's like 3 years ago. And the title, I believe the title of that message, the Sunday service that week was The Greatest is Love, right? So if it's December 4th, what does that mean? December 4th, 2018, that actually is a Tuesday. Right? That's a Tuesday, if you think about that, right? December 4th, 2018 is a Tuesday, and it's well into the week about the title is The Greatest is Love. And just the song itself is an epic song. And what Sunseem said that I think that we need to really understand is this song should move you to tears because it is God speaking. Right? It's God speaking to us. What life is there without love? Right? All things were created because of love. And what is this love? Right? What, like, if you think about how powerful this love is, if this love is the cause for God to create everything, this love is something that's bigger than all these things. It's worth all this creation and this time that God has put into it and all this heartache. And, it's really unfortunate in one sense when he says you're not going to really understand deeply unless you go into the spiritual world to see this love. And it's kind of unfortunate because most of the people won't really be able to go into the spiritual world. But we have to be those that listen carefully to those that do. And basically it seems like I sang this song because I know. I've been to the spirit. I know how deep, I understand deeply, right? That what this love is, this love that caused God to create all things. The universe, galaxies, planets, human beings, animals, this love is so great, it caused God to do all these things. So when we all understand the purpose of creation, right? We are created to fulfill this great love that created all things. So, you know, it's something where we have to re-listen to that song over and over again, right? The lyrics are that deep. And we have to be those that don't love in some type of mediocre way, but we have to really love and understanding how great this love is. So I like that one thing that he said about people who are, you know, speaking against providence and slanderers. It's like, look where they are, right? These are people criticizing while they're sitting in death, right? They're on that path. So it's quite interesting is, like, imagine you're on the right path and the people that are slandering against you are the ones that are not even in the path. Right? They're kind of outside, like screaming in. And it's like this, guys. When you see how the internet is and how social media is, how people chime in on everything, saying bad things about this and bad things about that, when they haven't even tried it, they don't even know what these people are going through, but they just kind of start talking trash and like hating people so much. They're sitting in a completely different place, right? So, and I like that last point also is basically, you know, you got to sing God songs. Right? And because these are God's songs that God created the melody for. The Holy Spirit created the lyrics. God created the melody. And we have to sing the songs from God. And if you really understand how deep these are, you'll sing and you'll cry while you're singing. So he even said, if you sing before me, sing the songs from God. Value the songs from God. And he says, like, if it was on a point scale, you'd get minimum 70 points just for singing one of God's songs, right? So we need to be set on fire with the lyrics of these songs. Know the lyrics, right? Understand the lyrics. And people on the outside, even people on the outside, like musicians, will look at them and say great songs. It's just the people who are not musical will say, well, it's okay. Oh, it's not really, doesn't fit me, whatever it is. So I hope that all of us here are really gaining a lot from the great songs. And we just got to kind of listen to them over and over again until we have that full understanding, right? So that I hope that is something that everyone can gain a little bit from the sermon of the songs and the sermon of the explanation of the songs, all right? So that is the word study for today for the great songs that happen on Wednesday. Awesome. So let's get into the final song for today, right? Just the song of choice. And since it's Friday, it's always a musical Friday, I'm going to go back to the classics, okay? Now, of course, there's like Phantom of the Opera, Cats, and all these classic ones. But this one was kind of came out on TV first with John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John. And this is from the musical Grease, right? I know this really well because I made a music video to this song, and also my brother was in the musical Grease in high school too, so that was kind of cool. And this song is probably like one of the there's Summer Nights, which is like probably the best one out of the entire musical, but the second best one is a really fun one called Grease Lightning. All right, guys, so this is from the musical Grease with Grease Lightning featuring John Travolta.
This car could be systematic, hydromatic, traumatic. Woo! Well, I could be Grease Lightning.
Grease Lightning. We'll get some overhead lifters and four barrel quads, oh yeah.
Keep talking, we'll keep talking.
Fuel injection cut off and chrome plated rods, oh yeah.
We'll get already,
with a 4-speed on the floor, they'll be waiting at the door. You know that ain't a shit, we'll be getting lots of tin.
Grease Lightning.
Go Grease Lightning, you're burning up the quarter.
And there you go. That is John Travolta from the movie musical, right? That was on TV with Olivia Newton-John. That is the musical Grease with Grease Lightning. Yes, John Travolta started off singing and dancing. Like this musical put him on top. There was also Saturday Night Fever. Oh my gosh, that's when he was dancing like crazy too. Super popular down at that time. All right, so we are coming to the last segment of today's podcast. And of course, it is Friday. So the last segment, we always go to the MBTI 16 personality with Wonchun. So everyone, please enjoy and please welcome Wonchun.
Hey everyone, this is Wonchun with some more discussion on MBTI. If you're new or you need more content to understand today's topic, head to 16 Personalities to get some basics on the 16 types, or you can go to Personality Junkie to understand cognitive functions. So today's topic is for ISFJs and INFJs, tertiary TI. Anyway, let's get into it. Right. Firstly, though, we need to check out what the auxiliary function for the ISFJ and the INFJ is. So the auxiliary function is FE, extroverted feeling, and that sits next to their dominant function in the front seat. So imagine a car, you got dominant driver, you got an auxiliary function, which is the second. It supports the dominant. They work together hand in hand, and they should, when they're healthy, you know, do really well together. You know, think of a relationship with someone else. And then you have the tertiary function, which is a little bit weaker. It sits at the back behind the auxiliary function. And next to the tertiary in the back, you have inferior function. That's the weakest of them. All right. So, yeah, we need to kind of learn a little bit about the auxiliary function, FE. And this will kind of, you know, this directly influences how we start to think about this TI, this tertiary function, introverted thinking. All right, so their characteristics, FE, comes out as generally really caring, compassionate, you know, with that kind of attitude towards people. They're very open and trusting and, you know, helpful, generous with, you know, their time or just in general and overall just really enjoy expressing themselves. They set and also respect appropriate emotional boundaries. They adapt well in social situations, and also they have, you know, they can really contribute a lot, and then they tend to be quite objective and fair in understanding people and society. But, okay, this is the but, right? Not everyone is in that healthy state, but the chronic problems of underdeveloped FE kind of shows itself as being cynical or inexpressive, emotionally immature, unaware of their feelings, and unconsciously motivated by fear or an inferiority, inadequacy, and unhealthy, in their relationships with people, self-centered in their perception of people and or society. Right? So, as always, auxiliary function being second, you know, no matter how much you reject it or, you know, you block its growth or development, you know, for as long as you do it, it's going to be a problem. So FE, extroverted feeling, will start to try to establish a strong feeling or connection with the outside world, right, with the real world. The logical consequences, right, of not developing auxiliary FE properly is that people begin to really feel unable to fit in everywhere, anywhere, you know, despite how many times they've tried to invest emotionally or made, you know, positive contributions to whatever they're trying to be involved with. And this is where the problem lies, is as an immature ISFJ or INFJ, they'll try to connect to their TI tertiary function. You know, oh, it's not bad to connect to your tertiary function. Well, if you, you know, this is the thing, is like you start to misuse TI, your tertiary function, and you distance yourself from FE, extroverted feeling. So instead of going to FE to really resolve the problems and use it, you start to reject its use. Thus, a tertiary loop begins. And tertiary TI as an ISFJ and INFJ, they tend to, you know, concoct logical rationales to deflect any personal responsibility for any sort of detrimental or antisocial beliefs that they are having, and also their behaviors. You know, what they'll start to do is start blaming other factors for causing distrust, or, you know, having that distrust or feelings of insecurity. And then the thing is that TI loop. So we've been talking about the tertiary function and mostly like about this loop, right? Is that when you miss out this auxiliary function, you go directly to TI to help you out. And just to explain a little bit, like for an introvert, you know, with their dominant function as introverted, that auxiliary function, the second one, is always extroverted. But missing that, you go directly back to your tertiary function, which is also introverted. So you become heavily unbalanced. And then you start to feel rewarded by just jumping over and looping into your tertiary function because it's introverted, and you start to feel a sense of reward by resisting FE because it's like, oh, it's not comfortable. You know, just want to, you know, feel comfortable. And because you reject it, because it's like you refuse to use it because maybe it's caused you some sort of pain, it gives you a false sense of confidence in being really intelligent, smart, or strong, exceptional in some way, enough to avoid that external pressure, which, you know, provides a very convenient method to deny the chronic feeling of alienation. So, like, you just really reject it, and it gives you this false sense, this false idea that you're doing, you actually, start rewarding yourself for rejecting it. So, you guys, like, remember, you're always never really aware that you're doing this. You know, people aren't really aware at the time. And so, you know, you need someone to help you to self-analyze and be objective about it. Right. So in that TI loop, those tendencies or those characteristics, you know, always show through, right? So for the ISFJ, the INFJ, when you're in that TI loop, you tend to be emotionally dysfunctional, causing, you know, your personal life to kind of fall into a really poor state. You start to believe in yourself, like you're in one self, in your own, that you're self-aware and that you really understand what's going on, but you're unable to really fully be honest or be honest about your own feelings. You tend to overthink and be full of contradictions, yet only trust your own judgment. You use blame or control or faulty beliefs to separate yourself from emotional insecurities. You claim to be true to yourself, but you get motivated by the reactions to social pressure. You project your shame and your guilt into pointless criticisms and also disapproval. You tend to emphasize reason, yet can't explain yourself or accept criticism from others. And you become really obstinate, and you use, you know, your intelligence, like performative intelligence, to prove your self-worth, you know, and you become really competitive. Right, guys, so if you're in this state, I hope you can get help. You know, often the cases that we are, and it doesn't, you know, it's not for long sometimes, but the big problem is that, you know, we need to be aware of ourselves, right? And some people can be in that state for a long time, you know, years even, totally not being true to themselves, not fixing their problems when it comes to personality. So I hope, you know, I hope you can all put concerted effort into really developing your TI into adulthood, right? Suddenly, you know, the thing is that people, as they get older, they suddenly just start developing themselves, and they become really assertive, self-sufficient and capable, and really coherent, you know, really following through with what they believe in. You know, obviously, well, not obviously, you know, they become more self-aware, hopefully, right? You know, understanding about who they are, their problems, acknowledging themselves. You know, that happens over time sometimes, But of course, you know, if we put a lot of effort into it, we can make it happen a lot faster. And what we want is for the ISFJ, ISFJs, we want that balance between FE and TI. That's really important, having those two in the middle just working hand in hand together with the dominant function. Guys, thank you so much again for joining. I really appreciate it. Please continue to persevere no matter the obstacles and continue to develop your personalities, making yourself together with the Lord. Peace. See you later. Bye.
And thank you so much, Wonchan, for another wonderful episode of the MBTI 16 Personalities. Gosh, there is so much information on the 16 Personalities. You could probably do this for years and years to come. I honestly would like to see a show that he does on his own, right? Like maybe a video show that we could put on this channel too, but that would be amazing and great. Either way, so happy, so thankful that he's putting all this work. He's been over a year already. That was episode 53, so that's like 52 weeks plus one, which means over a year. Congratulations to Wonchan for always being consistent and putting in this work to make these the 16 Personalities show. All right, either way, that is the end of today's Friday podcast and also the last segment for the entire week. I hope you guys have an amazing, amazing weekend. There's going to be the Espresso with Sky. We're going to have the video tonight on why I quit drinking alcohol. And then Sunday with the Sunday edition with Nick Loader from Australia. And then we'll see you guys again on Monday on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive 117.8. You're soaring up with Sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head